we have learned about measurement of length. So the next topic is measurement of mass or weight. So let us today learn about measurement of mass or weight, children. And then later we are going to learn about measurement of capacity also. So let me just begin with this second one, that is measurement of mass or weight. Children, weight tells us how heavy or light an object is, isn't it? How heavy or light an object is. The unit for measuring weight are kilograms, grams, and milligrams. The unit of measuring weight is kilograms. That is kg, and then grams. And milligrams gm. So children, smaller weights are measured in grams. Smaller weights are measured in grams, and heavy weights are measured in kilograms. And heavy weights are measured in kilograms. So the standard unit of mass or weight is kilogram. The standard unit of mass or weight is kilogram. So we use a beam balance and an electronic balance to measure weight. You can just see the picture here. So we use beam balance or electronic balance to measure weight. So when you go to shops, nowadays you can see electronic balance. So the shopkeeper will use this electronic balance. But in older days and all, so they used to use more beam balance. So nowadays in markets also you can see, in vegetable markets the vendors will be having this beam balance, and then you can see the different kinds of weights on that. It will be written 1 kg or 500 gram like that. So you can just see that one. So using that weights, they will measure the weight, children. And 1 kg is equal to 1000 gram, and 1 gram is equal to 1000 mg. Okay, 1000 milligram. Children, just remember this one. So you can just see the this one here, the instruments you can see here. So that is beam balance and electronic balance. So whenever you go to shop, you just observe how the shopkeeper will use this electronic balance. Automatically it will show the this one capacity there, how much we are buying, what is the measure of the weight there. Okay, let me move on to the next point, that is measurement of capacity. So you can just see in the picture here, you can see the markings also there, children. You can see 100 ml, 250 ml, 200. You can just different you can see the different markings on that. The capacity of a container is the quantity of the liquid it can hold. Okay, the capacity of a container is the quantity of the liquid it can hold. So you can just example, you can see the jars, bottles, containers or buckets or different this one is available in the market. So children, a small vessel will have less capacity and compared to the big vessel. Okay, a small vessel will have less capacity compared to the big vessel. The units for measuring capacity are, the units of measuring capacity are liters, that is L, and milliliters, ml. Okay, the units of measuring capacity are liters and milliliters. However, the standard unit of measuring capacity is liters. The standard unit of measuring capacity is liter. Smaller capacity is measured in milliliter, and larger capacity is measured in liters. So you can just see, you can just observe when on the syrup bottles and on the cap, there are different markings on that. So 2.5 ml, 5 ml, 7.5 ml. So if you go to doctor, you prescribe to take 5 ml or 2.5 ml. That is the smaller capacity. So it shows the smaller capacity. You can measure in that, and you can take that one. So like that. And then whereas the larger capacity is measured in liters. Okay, like 2 liters, 10 liters or 5 liters like that. So larger capacity is measured in liters. The instrument used to measure capacity are measuring cylinders and measuring cans. Measuring cylinders and measuring cans. So measuring cylinders and measuring cans, you can see here when the milkman will bring the milk to then he will come and supply the milk to children. So you can just observe that. So you will be having that measuring cans and all that markings will be there. So, so it is the standard unit. It is the standard unit of measuring capacity. Then we can. So we has to correctly has to measure and has to give the. Can't do any mistakes there. Okay. So that markings are there. So we can use that one for measuring the capacity of liters there. So till this 1 liter is equal to 1 liter is equal to 1000 ml. Okay. So larger capacity it is measured in liters and the smaller capacity is measured in milliliters. Okay, children. So let me end my class here. In the next class, so let us learn about measurement of time and measurement of temperature. I hope you have understood, children. So you can just observe the markings on the syrup bottles if you are having at home. You can just observe the smaller capacity on that. You can just observe the markings on that. And if you are having measuring cans, you can just see that one. Okay, children. So we'll see you in the